police are on the hunt for the Grinch who stole Christmas and stole from Mikey Nichols. He's 18 years old now. He was a star hockey player who was on the ice during a game, hit in the back by another player, and his neck was broken. Since then, he's been a paraplegic. So I chased this to the scene of the crime, and I saw a little two-year-old putting in money into the donation box. And the Close family, this was their home, it took them 3 months to put all the lights on the house. All of that money that they're getting donations is for Mikey to help him.
So it goes direct to him.
Directly to Mikey to help him in his condition.
It shocked me, not only because a donation box was stolen from me, it was just that any sort of donation box was stolen, period.
It was stolen sometime between Sunday night and Monday morning.
How much money was stolen?
We estimate between $250 and $400. And my initial reaction was I couldn't believe it because we've never had anything like that happen in the 10 years we've been doing this.
So they have put a new donation box. It's attached to a tree, padlocked with a huge chain, and there's actually a lock on top of it. I chased it to Mikey's home, and I asked Mikey, what would you say to the thief who stole your money?
I'm more angry that they took the money from the Reed Foundation and the big idea and the great things that they're doing, because in the future that's going to help so many people, and I just wanted to continue to help them and everyone else. But
I spoke to his father, who said that the expenses for Mikey are astronomical and they really appreciate everybody's help. He gave me a tour of the house. There's the former living room, which is now Mikey's bedroom.
We've had so many volunteers that have donated their time, and labor is costly.
Right.
So as far as labor is concerned, that hasn't been astronomical. Construction materials, on the other hand, are different.
His wheelchair costs $40,000. He showed me this apparatus that's on the ceiling that lifts Mikey from his bed to the shower and to the bathroom, which costs $15,000. They also showed me this wheelchair ramp that was installed on the outside of the house. It was expensive for them, and all they did was buy the wood. The price of maintaining Mikey's lifestyle, just for him to live day by day, is just growing. So it's really a shock.
Look, the guy, whoever stole it, is a dirtbag, and forgetting even the time of year, just the person they're stealing from. But I have to ask the question. Why do it this way? It seems so old-fashioned and antiquated to have a donation box with cash. Why are we not on Facebook? Why is this not electronic? I think you'd reach a lot more people doing that.
But you know who's putting money in a donation box? Two-year-olds. So that is the best way for two-year-olds to really appreciate Christmas.
Okay.
And I saw a lot of kids there.
Yeah, so we can put something on our Facebook page to help this kid out.
Actually, you can't donate on the Facebook page. You can go to that house in East Brunswick and donate and help out Mikey.
Okay.